Tonight's Health Watch, we've all heard about hackers hitting computer networks, banks, and even cars.
Well, now a warning that hackers could hit people's hearts. CBS 2's Dr. Max Gomez tells us that pacemakers are vulnerable. Dr. Max?
That's right, Jessica and Alice. You know, not just pacemakers, all sorts of medical devices run wirelessly off computer networks. And even though many of these devices are lifesavers or life supporters, they are surprisingly unprotected against cyber attack. If you feel vulnerable when you're in the hospital, it turns out you've got company. So is the hospital itself.
It's a medical device, but the way this thing runs is it's really just a computer.
Cybersecurity expert Billy Rio says many medical devices, such as this IV pump, are connected wirelessly to a centralized computer network, making it easier to monitor. But that also means...
By design, you're allowing it to where someone else can control this thing remotely and do things to the pump or to do things to the device or equipment. You have to understand what you're doing before you do this.
Rios examined a number of popular hospital infusion pumps, and the results were chilling.
You could basically log into this device with no username and no password.
Which means just about any hacker with an internet connection could remotely operate the device or change its settings. The same is reportedly true of people's personal medical devices, such as insulin pumps and heart pacemakers. The danger is serious enough that former Vice President Dick Cheney had his pacemaker's wireless function disabled. But Rios says most device manufacturers are slow to fix what they consider only theoretical problems.
Now, normally what has to happen is we have to wait for someone to be killed, right? So, and that's not a good position to be in. We don't want someone to have to die in order for them to become a data point in order for us to make a decision.
Because of Rios's research, the FDA has issued an alert warning health providers to discontinue use of some specific IV pumps. But because there's no actual defect, there was no requirement to do so, which also means there is no guarantee that the person controlling your life-saving device is someone with your best interest at heart. Now, part of the problem is, who's going to pay the cost of adding security to an old machine, which can get expensive when hospitals could easily have dozens or even hundreds of IV infusion pumps? Manufacturers may only offer a fix if hospitals purchase new models from them. Now, again, this hasn't happened. It's unusual, but you don't want to wait for something really bad to happen before you add some kind of a cybersecurity there. It's kind of wide open right now.
Who would have thought?
Yeah, something to look out
for. Well, I think that's part of the problem. Nobody really thought about it, that they're all operating on a computer network, and that network is vulnerable, so you can get into it via the network.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Max.
You bet.